And this evening we welcome to the studio the Point of Air Band, conducted by Malcolm Brownbill. This week is, of course, a pretty busy one for many brass bands, because it's Whit Week. That means there have been processions galore during the last few days, processions of witness, they call them, when many local churches and chapels, with members of their congregations and all the scholars from their Sunday school all dressed up in their new clothes, take to the streets, walking around the district, often holding open-air services. Bands have always played a leading role in these affairs, no pun intended, and though this kind of event isn't as widespread as it used to be, there are still quite a few of these processions, especially in the Northwest. And traditionally, a lot of them are held not on Whit Sunday, but on Whit Friday, which is the Friday after Whit Sunday, and that means this coming Friday. One of the important side events to this day is, of course, the Whit Friday Contest. This idea was started up over 100 years ago when, with having so many bands around, the locals said, let's have a contest. And so, apart from the processions, many bands are right now preparing to play in as many as they can of the 20 or so contests that will be taking place in the Oldham area on Friday. I wonder how many of them will play this march. Ravenswood. William Rimmer's wonderful march, Ravenswood. And if you happen to be in Upper Mill or Dobcross or Mosley or any one of more than a dozen other villages on Friday evening, I reckon you'll hear a few performances of that and a host of other marches. By the way, it came out number 20 in You Know What. On now to our overture. It comes from a Supé operetta of 1865. It's arranged by Gordon Langford and played by the Point of Air Band. Here's the beautiful Galatea.
Thank you.
Beautiful Galatea, one of the lesser-known overtures by Franz von Suppé, from an operetta in which Pygmalion, a legendary king of Cyprus, makes himself an ivory statue of Galatea. The statue is very beautiful, and he falls in love with it. Miraculously, the statue comes to life. They dance, and they dance, and they dance. And then they get married. And then, well, as far as I know anyway, they live happily ever after. What a magical moment it must have been when that statue actually came to life. Perhaps it's summed up in the title of our next item, a soprano solo, One Moment in Time.
Thank you.
One Moment in Time, which was, of course, the anthem of the Seoul Olympics. It was made famous by Whitney Houston, and it was arranged as a soprano solo by one of the percussionists of the band, Wynn Pearson. Ian Davis was the soloist, and Malcolm Brownbill conducted the Point of Air Band. The band was founded as recently as 1967. The main sponsors are IMCO, the mining machinery firm, but support is also given by the Point of Air Colliery Welfare. During recent years, the band has won first prizes in the Pontins Finals, the Welsh National Ice Steddfod, the Leeds Open Championship, and also in the BBC Radio Wales Band of the Year programme. So, with such a record behind them, they say with confidence to their rivals, "Watch your step." Remrew's catchy Watch Your Step, composed originally for the Philip Jones Brass Ensemble, in which Ray plays bass trombone, but played there in an arrangement for brass band by Howard Snell. And to take us into our halfway record interlude, we have another piece originally written for the Philip Jones Group, by Elgar Howarth. It was featured on a record called Philip Jones in Switzerland, a very popular one, and it wasn't long before Grimethorpe were playing Howarth's version for full band. It's based on a jaunty little Swiss folk song, and it's the Bern Patrol. Thank you. And us. But back now to the studio, where our guest band Point of Air is conducted tonight by Malcolm Brownbill. We stay on the other side of the Atlantic as they take us into the second half with a number made famous by that wonderful American group, the Carpenters. The arrangement is by Stephen Sykes, and it features four soloists. On the top line is the principal cornet player, Geraint Jones, who we've just heard on disc. On flugelhorn, there's Ian Brownbill, son of Malcolm. On tenor horn, we have John Thackeray, and David Roberts plays the euphonium. Here's We've Only Just Begun. Stephen Sykes' arrangement of the old Carpenters hit, We've Only Just Begun. Maybe it's a bit late in the programme to be saying that, but it's surprising how time flies when you're enjoying yourself. And to add to your enjoyment, I hope, here's a march. And a Welsh one it is, too, boyo, one of the three written by the March King of Wales, T.J. Powell, all called after castles which form a triangle surrounding that part of Wales where the composer lived and worked. There was Caerphilly Castle, Carnarvon Castle, and this one, the best known of the three, Castell Coch. Thank you. Castell Coch, or as we lesser mortals usually say, Castle Coch. It was composed by the Suzer of Wales, Tom Powell, and played by the Point of Air Band under Malcolm Brownbill. Malcolm is not the band's permanent conductor, though he does work with them from time to time. In fact, he conducted them in their much publicised win at the Leeds Open Championships last year. He's had a varied career, having played cornet, trumpet and piano, and has been involved in both brass and military bands, as well as with orchestras. Between 1970 and 1985, his full-time job was as director of music to the Merseyside Police Band, a military band, as you'll know if you come from those parts. Since retiring from the police, he's been teaching in the Wigan and Liverpool areas, and over the years he's conducted several brass bands, including Wingates, Rochdale, and more recently the newly formed La Porte Band from Warrington. Well, tonight he's fronting the Point of Air Band, and we stay with the music of Wales in an arrangement by Denzil Stevens, who puts the spotlight on the euphonium in that most famous of all famous Welsh tunes, Myfanwy. Here's David Roberts again.
Thank you.
Paris Mevanwy, arranged by Denzel Stevens and played by David Roberts with the Point of Air Band from North Wales, conducted by Malcolm Brownbill. For our finale, we turn from Wales to Spain for the exciting ritual fire dance by Manuel de Falla. Manuel de Falla's Ritual Fire Dance. It was played by the Point of Air Band, conducted by Malcolm Brownbill, and it brings to an end tonight's programme. I'm Roy Newsome, and my producer is Anthony Askew. We both hope you've enjoyed our programme this evening, and that you'll be back with us at the same time next Wednesday, when once again, with a little help from the William Davis Construction Group Band, we'll invite you to listen to the band. Listen to the Band is a BBC North East production. Now the time, it's 5 minutes.
welcome once again to Sounding Brass. And the things are beginning to hot up now in the Radio Wales Brass Band Competition for 1990. Last week, we heard Lewis Merthyr, who were awarded 250 points. Well, this week, it's band number 8's turn to try to win favour with our three adjudicators for the competition, Ian Morgan, Ken Lloyd and David Thomas. Well, there are now only three more bands to hear in round one. They are Christy Tyler Corey, Llan Rhyg and Point of Air Amco. Still top of the league at the moment are BTM with 278 points. In second place with 277 points are National Fuel Distributors, and in third place at the moment are Tredegar Town with 267. Now, let me also remind you that neither our adjudicators or myself know yet who band number 8 is. Only my producer knows, and he keeps things well and truly under his hat. So, without further ado, let's hear band number 8's opening number, a very famous march, The Senator. George Allen's famous march, The Senator, played by band number 8 in our competition. David Thomas, how did you like the performance of The Senator?
I liked it a lot, yes, I did. It was super march tempo, but not as a marching march tempo. It was one of those tempos, you know, not a marching march tempo.
We couldn't have a gate to this with you.
You mentioned gate, I've come in for a lot of stick. from bandsmen. You mentioned, I think, David, for band number 3, which was Park and Dare, about their gait. Now, a lot of bands were saying, oh, David Thomas and his gait. Can you once more explain this? Is this gate open or shut?
Well, open. It was always open for me, anyhow. This gait, I mean, it's your stride, isn't it? It's your pace, you see.
Yeah.
When you're marching, you need to be just right. Now, this is a contest march, we just know, the Senator.
Yes, so there's
just a little bit brighter.
So the benefit of the listeners, you've got contest marches, yes, which often are much more technically difficult, aren't they? I mean, unplayable on the march because they're just florid work all over the place, aren't they?
Yes,
and
indeed.
You've got your standard road march.
Yes,
so this is a contest march.
Oh, yes, contest march, most definitely. Yes.
So it's got a lot of intricacies to get along.
Yeah, it has indeed.
Did this band cope with it?
They did indeed. Super march tempo for me. I thought the soloist rather pecked his first subject solo. Mm-hmm. Just a little bit stilted. Ends of phrases weren't as tight as I'd like them to be, because it's obviously a very good band.
Mm-hmm.
Very good band. But yes, end of phrases just a little loose. And we went into the trio, and I thought the trio was absolutely smashing, lyrical. Everybody played very, very well from there on. It was just the initial part of the march that just caused me a little concern.
Generally, quite a good start then to band number 8.
Oh, yes.
Yes, very good.
Right, well, for the next item, we're going to hear music arranged by Gordon Langford. And we've heard his name, I think, quite a lot in this competition. And really, why not? Because he's done some smashing arrangements.
Excellent.
Yeah. Well, this is his very effective arrangement of Blow the Wind Southerly. blow the wind southerly, the traditional tune arranged by Gordon Langford. Ken Lloyd, did you enjoy that performance?
I did. Very nicely done. I thought the cornet, horn, euphonium at the beginning was well catered for. A little hint of hooding when the band joined in, but it did not affect the overall performance for me. And the very good playing and good balance throughout.
Good. Well, let's now hear from the soloist in this band, in band number 8. The music's by Brahms. It's adapted by Rafael Mendez and arranged as a cornet solo by Derek Barnes. Hungarian Dance number 5. Hungarian Dance number 5, a la Rafael Mendez, arranged as a cornet solo. Well, with that sort of arrangement, Ken Lloyd, would Brahms have been turning in his grave?
No, no, indeed. Why should he? I thought it was a very good arrangement and well handled by the soloist.
The soloist is obviously technically very competent, very experienced player. And the tone was very much like Harry James, not Mendez. Mm. And the jazz section suited him particularly well. Terrific, I think that was. I just started to concern a little bit in that three pieces we've heard so far. The cornet soloist has played very much alike in that style.
Yes, there was a bit for cornet solos at the beginning indeed, of Blow the Wind Southerly.
Indeed. I'm just a little concerned that even in brass bands we should have a bit more perception to enable the musician to vary the tone, you know, in different styles required within the musical styles itself. You know what I mean?
I think he did this in the blues part, didn't he? He just started to do it.
That's almost setting bands apart these days. There are, some bands are managing to do it, isn't it? To play the style of, say, the 30s and the 50s, and it is so difficult for, let's face it, amateur musicians in the main to pick this up.
It takes a very, very good player to do that.
Indeed. Yes,
indeed. But I feel this is a very good player.
Very good player.
Oh, yes.
Very good player. And I think he or she should actually even think about that, if it's not too late.
Well, let's now hear the final item from band number 8 this week. Last week, we heard Stephen Roberts' arrangement of Another Opening, Another Show, played by Lewis Merthyr. Well, here's another fine arrangement from Stephen of music that's said to have been written by Henry VIII. Band number 8 closed their programme with Pass Time with Good Company. Stephen Roberts' exciting arrangement of Pastime with Good Company. Well, before we hear the summing up and points from Ian, Ken and David, let's keep the suspense up a little longer as we take our usual look and see what's on this week's notice board. The Gwine Kai Gerwin Band are holding a sponsored blow next Saturday, the 16th of June, with contributions going towards their centenary fund. The event will be held at the Cwm Gorse Rugby Club, starting at 9 o'clock in the morning and finishing at 7 o'clock at night. Any local players who'd like to join in are welcome to go along at any time during the day, along with anyone who'd just like to listen to the music. That's Gwine Kai Gerwin's sponsored blow at Cwm Gorse Rugby Club on June the 16th. Paul Williams, secretary of Lewis Merthyr Band, who were on Sounding Brass last week, has written to us with news that the band have just signed up two ex-Corey players, Roy Roberts on solo euphonium and Hugh Williams on E-flat bass. And now they're looking for a second euphonium and first baritone players. Anyone interested can contact Paul on Tonopandy 422-894. That's first baritone and second euphonium players required for Lewis Merthyr Band. And the number to ring is Tonopandy 422-894. And don't forget, tickets are now available for the final of our 1990 Radio Wales Brass Band competition, which will be recorded on Saturday, June the 30th at 3 o'clock in our studios here at the BBC in Llandaff. The tickets are free, and you can get yours by writing to Sounding Brass, enclosing a stamped addressed envelope. Here's the address to write to. It's Sounding Brass, room 2002, BBC Radio Wales, Cardiff, CF5 2YQ. That's Sounding Brass, room 2002, BBC Radio Wales, Cardiff, CF5 2YQ. And now it's time to find out what our three adjudicators thought of band number 8. Ken Lloyd, can we have your comments first, please, on this performance?
Yes, well, the March Senator, very good playing by the band, especially the trio. I thought the cornet and euphonium and the accompaniment very well balanced indeed. I enjoyed Blow the Wind Southerly, and here again, the band played very well, especially in balance. I thought they were very, very good in balance. We've already talked about the cornet solo, and especially would like to mention there the change of the soloist to the blues tempo. I thought he handled that very, very well. Pastime with good company, a very good style for this type of piece, and I thought the band handled it well. In fact, a well contrasted programme, which I felt showed off the band.
Do you agree? Yeah, Morgan?
Yes, I agree. I enjoyed the Senator March, this well-known march. They opened out very, very well indeed. And I thought the euphonium and cornet played nicely together and good balance throughout the band. Blow the Wind Southerly, again, pleasing sounds throughout the band, and they move on to a good close. The Hungarian Dance number 5, a bold start with the soloist, who I thought played along with confidence and good technique. I enjoyed this item, and I thought the soloist played very, very well. The last item, good opening with trombone and percussion, and the overall sound of the band was quite pleasing. Perhaps just a little more clarity with the bass figure. But overall, this final item was played with confidence by a good band. A well-played programme with good choice of music and fine soloist.
All right, two good sets of comments there. Dave Thomas.
I completely agree with Ken on the Senator. The best playing for me was definitely in the trio area, definitely. I'll skip the Southerly one a minute. The soloist, I think I've said enough about that. The last item they played, Pastel Good Company, stylish and skillfully arranged item, very good. For the most part, it had the poise, but it took time to settle, I felt. It culminated into an exciting finish. There were, however, occasions when the playing was aggressive. Not assertive, aggressive. It was a super arrangement. And just to top that, I thought this, once again, this had a very good entertaining aspect with quality arrangements, but the playing generally at a high level. But unfortunately, we did have aggressive playing once or twice.
You don't like aggressive playing.
Well, there's no need for it.
Well, could it have been competitive playing?
No, just went over the top.
Yeah.
Just went over the top. And I hope the instrumentalists will know who they are. It certainly comes out on the recording anyhow. They begin the wind, begin, or even blow the wind southerly.
Yeah.
Blow the wind southerly. Now, I know this piece very, very well. And tradition has it that Kathleen Ferrier is the only performer of this piece of music. The only performer. And she is singing of a little boat called a bark, bringing her lover back, you see, a little bark, little boats. So it's got to be a nice, warm, gentle breeze. And I just felt it didn't quite get that. And in fact, it should be in 6-8, probably, this. And towards the middle section, I certainly had a 3-4 feel to it. I expect certainly bands of this calibre now, you see, we've got quite a disparity in the standard of bands, haven't we? Well, that's obvious. Some very, very good bands, and some bands with lesser attributes. So, to me, I think this band should have captured this style exactly right, and it just didn't do it.
Mm. Interesting point there. I particularly myself enjoyed the Pastime with Good Company because it was a unique item so far in the competition. We've had nothing of this era before.
Yes, very good.
Breath of fresh air, I felt.
Yes, I agree. And Stephen Roberts has come up with very good arrangements for this competition, hasn't
yes,
he?
Yes, he has, yeah. It's a good programme content for our average Radio Wales listener.
Very good choice.
Very good indeed.
Excellent.
The Panthers will love it.
Well, let's see if band number eight will love the points that you give them. let's first of all ask Ian Morgan for your points, please, for band number eight.
89.
Ken Lloyd?
90.
90. Can't split them again this week, David. What are you going to give them?
89
as well.
First time he tied.
Second time.
So, let's, while they're counting up the points next door, now open the envelope. Are we making any guesses, gentlemen, as to who this band might be?
I'm not.
No. Right, well, the band this week is Point of Air IMCO. Conducted by Hugh McGarrell, and no prizes, I think, for guessing the cornet soloist in the Hungarian Dance Number 5 was our old friend Jim Davis.
Still Jim?
Yes. Recently joined the band back from Brickhouse and Rostock, isn't
he? Interesting.
And they tell me the points for Point of Air are 268 points. Now, that's changed things considerably, because it now means that Tredegar Town, who've been holding third place for quite some time in the competition, are now down into fourth place. Still at the top, Bedrister Thomas and Mackin with 278 points. National Fuel Distributors are in second place at 277 points. And now, Point of Air, our new third place band, with 268 points. And that now means that with only two bands left to hear, Bedrister Thomas and Mackin band are guaranteed a place in the final. So, let's see what happens next week as we listen to band number 9 of the competition. And let's remind you that next week is either going to be Sam Reek Silver or Christy Tyler Corey. So I hope you can join me, Nigel Seaman, and our three adjudicators, Ian Morgan, Ken Lloyd, and Dave Thomas, for round 9 of the Radio Wales competition. That's next week on Sounding Brass. Until then, goodbye for now.